What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to set up Tebex on your Apex Minecraft server. Hosting a Minecraft server has a ton of benefits, such as the ability to completely control and customize the gameplay, but sometimes dedicated hardware costs money to manage and use. If you're looking for a way to make some money on your Minecraft server, then let me introduce you to Tebex, a piece of software that allows you to make a web store for your server. Setting this up can be complicated, which is why our system has this software built in for your convenience. This automatically configures everything, but there's still other steps needed to personalize your web store, so let's go over how to do it. Before creating your own web store for the game server, you'll need to automatically install Tebex through the panel. Head towards your Apex server panel, then click Monetization at the bottom left corner, and on the next page, you can fill out your first and last name and email address. Afterwards, press the Install button to confirm your information, and once you're done, you can check your email's inbox for a Set Up Your Tebex Account email. While viewing it, click the Setup Account button to get started, and on the next page, enter your password in the text box and click Setup Account. There's a lot to do with this Tebex web store, such as making new pages for community guidelines, custom sidebars to help reach server goals, creating items to sell, and other features. All of this is accessible through the Tebex dashboard. Before creating packages to sell in your web store, you're going to want to understand some important details. These include the basics of making an item and tweaking it accordingly, such as making it a subscription or limiting how many times the user can buy it. Additionally, it's best to set up categories for these packages, like having ranks or anything else you want. This makes it easier for players to navigate through the web store and begin buying items. Head towards your dashboard and click Packages near the top left corner, and continue to press Add New in the top right and select the Category option. Type in your desired name and description, and then tweak other settings down below. And when you're finished, you can click the Create button at the bottom to save the changes. If it's successful, you'll see Category Successfully Created appear down below. For packages, head back into the dashboard and click Packages on the left-hand side. And under your empty category, press Create One to begin making the item. Continue to enter the name and description of this package along with any other options, and then type your desired price and configure the other settings until you're satisfied. Scroll down and click Game Server Commands, and afterwards select your server from the Game Servers option. Once you've done this, press Add Command to the right and you can enter your commands here. And after you're done, you'll be able to press Update. Making a custom page for your players to visit gives you the ability to establish game rules, advertise your Discord server, or anything else you might have in mind. Navigate towards your dashboard, and then click on Web Store to the left and press Pages. And after that, click Create Custom Page near the top right corner. You can enter your desired information, such as title, slug, and content. And when you're finished, continue to press the Create button in the bottom left corner. The pages area for your web store is also where you're going to tweak the homepage. This is done by clicking Edit at the top and typing your desired content for it in the editor. When you're finished, make sure to press Update and review the changes, and keep in mind that it might take a few minutes for the new edits to actually appear on the web store. Another way to add extra content on the website is to use sidebars, which are almost always available to view. This might be the best way to include feature packages, support links, Discord servers, or anything else you might need to display. While on your dashboard, click Web Store and press Sidebar on the left-hand side, and then click Add Module to Sidebar at the top right corner of the page. Find your desired module and then press Create to begin the process. And then you can type or toggle content you want and click Create at the bottom. There are plenty of other features to try out with Tebex, such as connecting a domain, setting up website themes, integrating Discord with the software, creating discount sales, or banning specific customers. Most of these are straightforward as they're all accessible from the main dashboard. For example, clicking Discord reveals the ability to invite the Tebex bot to your server for extra activities. Other features might also have preparations, so we encourage you to reach out to Tebex support if you have any questions. Once you've made some sales with your Tebex game server, you can withdraw them into your bank or a PayPal account. Head towards your dashboard and click Payments, and then press Wallet on the left. And after that, log in with your Tebex account credentials on the new page. Create a wallet by filling out the requested information, and once you're logged in, click the Withdraw button in the top right corner. Add or choose an existing payout method, and then enter your amount in the text box. And when you're finished, press Request Withdraw at the bottom of the page. After this, an email should appear in your inbox regarding this withdrawal. Now, before we get into the common issues, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all of our future videos. If you're unable to locate the monetization button on your server panel, then this means your game doesn't currently support the feature. However, a manual installation and setup might work depending on Tebex's compatibility. If you're having this problem on your Minecraft panel, it might be caused by an unforeseen issue with our system, so make sure to reach out to our support team for help. If after creating your package, it fails to execute the commands, double check you've used the correct variables. For example, username is used to grab the player's name for the action. These values can be found in the variables list while creating or editing a package. And remember, these commands are executed by Tebex on your Minecraft server, so they have to be correctly entered. Once you've received and withdrawn money in your Tebex wallet, wait a few days to see if it sends successfully. In some cases, this can take 3 to 30 days for everything to work out. Most of the time, it won't be too much of an issue, but double-checking your payment method is heavily suggested, since any problem with them can result in a failed withdrawal. There's many benefits for using Tebex on your server, with making money being the main one. Other kinds include having a dedicated website and area for your players to use, along with other features to help connect your community together. At the end of the day, Tebex offers you a chance to monetize and enhance your community with almost endless possibilities.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.